Ticats have punched their ticket to Grey Cup 101. We're ready to find out how the West will be won from Calgary. It's become as bitter a rivalry as there is in the Canadian Football League. Today, the Saskatchewan Roughriders and the Calgary Stampeders in the 2013 Western Final.
For the visitors, Darian Durant's lost just one playoff game in his career. That last year in the semifinal against this Calgary team, where he threw in that game for over 400 yards and four touchdowns, coming off the win in the Western semifinal against the BC Lions a week ago. On the other sideline, Kevin Glenn, 4-5 as a starter in the playoffs. His last playoff action a year ago in the West Final against the BC Lions, where he started and won that game, took the Calgary Stampeders to the Grey Cup.
John Huffnagel's team at league best, 14-4. They were 8-1 at home, fifth Western Final in 6 years. Up against Corey Chamblin, 11-7 this year, trying to avenge the heartbreak of that Western semifinal last second loss last year here at McMahon. We're underway, and it'll be taken by Rob Cote, one of the up men. Saskatchewan won the toss, deferred to the second half. Kevin Glenn will lead Calgary offense out to start this game. Our starters to watch are brought to you by Napa Auto Parts, where custom advice comes standard.
Well, you heard the panel talk about it. A lot of talk this week about the two running backs in this game. And it starts with John Cornish, who led the Canadian Football League in rushing with 1,813 yards. There's Kevin Glenn on the season, really 10-2, because the last start of the year was a game all three quarterbacks played and didn't matter in the standings. Maurice Price is going to move in to slot back for Mark Wade McDaniel, who is injured.
Glenn 10-3, two game starts against Saskatchewan. First pass of the game is incomplete. Looking to the far side of the field for Joe West.
On defense, Saskatchewan Roughriders will not have Terrius George in the middle of defensive tackle and defensive line. That goes to Jermaine McIlvain. Does have playoff experience when you think back to his days in Montreal. Tyron Brackenridge is the nominee for Saskatchewan for top defensive player. And boy, we'll be watching Mike McCullough, the veteran of 15 playoff games, has his hands full here tonight with John Cornish.
Second and 10, Calgary. Glenn has time in the pocket and throws a completion, and a flag flies in the Calgary backfield as well, as Joe West has the catch. Would be short of the first down, but again, a flag has been tossed.
I think this may be going against Saskatchewan.
Roughing the passer, Saskatchewan, 95. 15 yards to the end of play, automatic first down.
So that's Ricky Foley, and already the Rough Riders have been tagged with more penalty yardage in this game than all of the Western semi.
And just three penalties in that game. Very disciplined against the BC Lions. Ricky Foley comes off the edge, takes an extra couple of steps and gives Kevin Glenn a two-hander in the back. Calgary Stampeders were short and get a new set of downs.
Yes, instead of a two and out, it's a first down at the Rough Rider 46-yard line. Double tight end formation. And the first carry of the game for John Cornish, and he is brought down quickly. That's Jermaine McIlvain in at defensive tackle for the injured Tay George.
John Cornish averaging over 100 yards per game on the ground in 2013. Finished the regular season on a tear. In fact, in the last five games it mattered, not counting the BC game that didn't count in the standings, he was averaging 141 yards per game. That's the goal now for Saskatchewan. Stop number nine if they can.
And Cornish with three consecutive 100-yard games in the playoffs. Limited to one on his first carry, so they'll empty the backfield. Second and nine. Keep on. That is picked off. And that is McIlvain. So two big plays by Jermaine McIlvain on the opening series. And the first turnover is committed by the Stampeders.
Talked about that playoff experience. Jermaine McIlvain was in the Grey Cup with Montreal for three straight years. Won two of them in 2009, 2010. And he reads this screen, does not rush the passer. Screens are set up to get the rush going deep past Kevin Glenn. Then he dumps it. Well, McIlvain never, ever rushes. He sniffed it out, slides underneath that screen from Glenn. The first turnover of this football game.
Roughriders tied for the lead in interceptions during the regular season, but that's an unlikely source to provide the first takeaway of the game. And Darian Durant goes to work in Calgary territory. He wants to throw. Heat is on. yards. So the first time he takes the snap, Darian Durant off and running.
Well, he started this game the way he finished the last one against the BC Lions in the 70 in the semifinal. 97 rushing yards against BC, 91 in the final 15 minutes. Corey Sheets, the number two running back in the Canadian Football League, over 100 yards in two of the three games versus the Stamps. Chris Getzlaf back in the lineup tonight with the knee brace on.
Fifth highest rushing total by a quarterback in CFL playoff history. A pass for Sheets out of the backfield is incomplete as Mayo tracked him, and a two and out to start for Saskatchewan.
Don't be surprised at all in this game to see the Calgary Stampeders defensively to spy on Darian Durant. Watch Jawan Simpson here. He's just going to be spying and sitting right at that linebacking spot waiting. Is Durant going to run? Is he going to run? Is he going to run? He's not going to flow to the football. We'll see a lot of that from Calgary, I'm sure, based on the semifinal.
Ricky Schmidt punting into a slight breeze. Skies this. That doesn't go very far. Taylor drops it and gets on it. Flags down as the Roughriders within the 5-yard halo. A no yards penalty after a 25-yard punt. Calgary back to work on offense when we return to the 2013 Western Final. The CFL playoffs on TSN are brought to you by Wendy's Ultimate Canadian Combo. Baconator and poutine. Wendy's. Now that's better. Diamond Ferry in the no yards area, so a 15-yard penalty. Second major penalty against the Roughriders in this first quarter. And Calgary back to work unscathed by that opening turnover with a first down at the Stampeder 43. Kevin Glenn to pass. And the quick hitter complete to Jabari Arthur, who had a catch in 17 of the regular season games, taking the place of the injured Nick Lewis.
Talked about the leading rusher in the Canadian Football League. Boy, John Cornish was close to setting an all-time mark for the Calgary Stampeders. When you look at top rushing running backs for the Calgary Stampeders in their history, 1961, Earl Lunsford. John Cornish finished second in that race, 2013, this year with his 1,800-plus. Willie Burton hangs on to the all-time best year as a Calgary Stampeder.
Second straight rushing title for Cornish. Second and four, the sweep, and Maurice Price bobbling the ball and knocks it out of bounds to avoid the turnover. And it will be a punting situation for Calgary. So the explosive Price trying to get it into his hands, but he mishandles the football.
Well, you know, for Maurice Price, this is a very different position. Maurice Price is a wide receiver. He's going to play at slot back. I mentioned off the top for Marquay McDaniel. A lot of different plays that he will be involved with, like this fly sweep, something he hasn't run much all season at all. Smart to just be the last one to knock it out of bounds, but couldn't find the handle on that one.
Minus 8, windchill minus 14, but that shouldn't be a problem for these teams today. Beck would love to order this up for next week, will we? There's Jock Sanders on the return, up over the 25-yard line, and Darian Durant back to work for the Roughriders, trying to guide his team to a home berth in the Grey Cup. CFL playoffs on TSN are brought to you by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Well, not the fireworks start that we got in the Eastern Final. Roughriders' second possession of the game starts at their 26. Corey Sheets. And he is taken down quickly. Jawan Simpson, the middle linebacker.
Take a look at a few players to watch in this game for the Calgary Stampeders defensively. First with Charleston Hughes, who is the Western Division top defensive player. Will go up against Chip Cox in that category, the player awards. Keon Raymond in two games in the playoffs last year had 8 tackles, 2 sacks, and an interception. And Brandon Smith led the team in tackles, maybe matched up against Dressler here at this one time.
One for Sheets. Second and 9, passing situation. Durant looks for Todd Smith. He's got him. In front of the corner, Chris Randall. And they'll mark him short of the, or around the first down. See how generous the spot is. It is enough to move the chains.
Now there are some changes for the Calgary defense. Take a look at the interior of their defensive line. No DeMonte Bolden and no Johnson in the middle. They'll go with Junior Turner and Etienne Legare in a rotation with Freddie Bishop. Experienced players in Turner and Etienne and Legare, but not starters.
Back in the hands of Sheets trying to exploit that weakness perhaps up the middle. Freddie Bishop's last game was August the 17th. There's Junior Turner. But that was a harsh finish for Calgary to the regular season, losing two defensive tackles.
Yeah, Micah Johnson, DeMonte Bolden out, not available for this game. So we'll watch this rotation. Junior Turner and Legare will rotate. Fred Bishop will start at the other spot. How much does Charleston using Cordero Law start to cheat to help the interior guys out? We'll watch for that.
Three for Sheet, second and seven at the 40. And the quarterback draws call. There is a flag as he's brought down for a loss back at the 37. There is Brandon Smith.
Well, you know one thing, the Calgary Stampeders after the semifinal
holding Saskatchewan 58. 50th decline. Third down.
Left tackle Xavier Fulton.
Saskatchewan Roughriders and Darian Durant running for those 97 yards in that game. The Calgary Stampeders will not be surprised by the quarterback drop. Now it's a matter of Saskatchewan then trying to block it up correctly, but it certainly won't be a surprise to them.
Larry Taylor awaits another high and short punt by Schmidt. And that'll be taken by Smith. It's another no yard situation, but Smith taking big yards down the field. And finally, on hurdles, Ricky Smith right inside the 10. That's a 48-yard return for Brandon Smith. It's the first 30-plus return of a punt by Calgary against Saskatchewan this year.
No yards. Saskatchewan. Penalty is declined. First down.
So Brandon Smith, one of the up men, takes advantage of the short boot. Cut the Rough Riders on their heels and rumbles 48 yards.
Take a look here at Brandon Smith, who's going to block on this return and then play heads-up football, veteran football in this playoff game, right to the left of your screen. He's blocking on the play, then realizes this ball is kicked way short by Ricky Schmidt, just a 22-yard punt. Heads-up veteran move to go get underneath that and pick up big yards.
Wind listed at southeast at 14 kilometers an hour. Shouldn't be that big a problem. Here's Cornish with Drew Tate in at quarterback. Inside the 10, it'll be second and goal, just a couple for number nine.
I agree with you, Chris. It's not that much of a wind here as Kevin Glenn comes back in this game, and just not a good kick by Ricky Schmidt has set up this opportunity for the Calgary Stampeders. Schmidt averaged 45 yards a kick on the regular season. Not just 22-yarder. Now, last week in the semifinal in the cold in Mosaic Stadium, he was around a 36-yard average.
So second and goal from the six. Kevin Glenn back in at quarterback. Short drop, and it's knocked down, batted down. John Chick gets a paw on the football, and that's a big stand by the Rough Riders after the field position set up by the punt return.
A little bit of a stunt there from John Chick. It looked like Kevin Glenn wanted to try and go to Maurice Price or John Cornish, one of the two out of the backfield. Cornish lines up in that single back. Here comes Price in motion coming down inside. And that's where he wanted to go. Now there was a little bit of a stunt on the defensive line. John Chick comes around from his defensive end spot, times his jump, and it hits him right in the chest.
So the most accurate kicker ever in a Canadian Football League season, with a chip shot to open the scoring here in the Western Final. Brady Parrott is, has put Calgary up by three. Brady Chris Getzlaff back in that huddle for the Saskatchewan Roughriders with more on his recovery. Here's Lee Jones.
Yeah, thanks a lot, Chris. He actually missed two games with that knee injury. It's the first time he's missed games due to injury in the CFL. Missing that Western semifinal, he said it was heartbreaking watching on the sidelines with his team playing and said he wanted to get back there as soon as possible. Now, they closed practice on Wednesday, put him through the motions, and felt like they saw enough to put him in this game, and they want him in this game. He has good history against Calgary. Of his 34 touchdowns, he's received 13 against the Stamps. That's about 38% in career regular season in playoffs.
Scott's league in receiving, and the top Canadian with a good run on first down. Chuck Sanders straight up the middle, and he has a first down run.
Good talk with him yesterday, as Chris Getzlaff told me he's to this hit he took against the Calgary Stampeders October 26th in the game to basically decide first place in the division. Did not play until this one tonight and was questionable all week long. Said he's never played with a brace. He's got one on now.
10 for Sanders. They emptied out six receivers. Are out to Weston Dressler. Has a catch across midfield and gets tossed down by Fred Bennett. Back-to-back first downs for Darian Durant to the Roughriders.
Now starting to mix it up a little bit with Jock Sanders on first down. Start to establish the run for Darian Durant. When this offense has been successful this year, it's been with tremendous balance. He comes back on the next play and hits the slant to Weston Dressler.
Last week, all skilled players for Darian Durant had touched the ball midway through the first quarter. Hand off, and Corey Sheets kicks it outside. First down run for Sheets, and he'll step out. Had a chat with the coach prior to the game about making every touch count. And he makes that one count for a first down and 12 yards.
Yeah, not about him anymore. Look what Calgary just did. They brought Eric Fraser, the safety, put him right up in the line of scrimmage, possibly help with the interior defensive tackles we talked about in NCAA. And Junior Turner, he gets the bubble and bounces it.
12 for Sheets, three consecutive first downs, and now Durant. Little dump off pass, and it's Neil Hughes with a straight arm. And he is written down by Darius Brooks.
The strength of the Saskatchewan team this year offensively has been their whole line up front, and they've got that starting unit back. Ben Heenan at right tackle, Xavier Fulton out left. Maybe the nastiest of the bunch is Chris Best at right guard. That matchup of Best and Brendan Labatt against Junior Turner and Etienne inside. We're watching that one.
Nine for the Regina product. Hughes at second and one. And Sheets takes the handoff. Left side. Big hole. Corey Sheets steps out and above the 20-yard line. So the Roughriders putting together a good drive, have another first down on another 10-plus run by Sheets.
The interior of that low O-line, as we talk, Chris, getting a little bit of a push. And what happens is Corey Sheets now gets room to make that move and then bounce it to the outside because of no interior penetration. There's the bounce. The bubble created.
At the 21, it's a big to Sheets, and a pass is caught. Tosh bounces off first contact to the 5.
Big game in the semi for Tosh Smith. 4 catches, just 4, but for 126 yards. His long on the game, a 53-yarder. As Darian Durant with that bounce. Little run to Corey Sheets and Jock Sanders. Little play action here, and against the flow of the play, going from right to left. He throws it inside, and Brendan Labatt getting that good push on Etienne Legare. Look at him working the old line.
15 for Smith, 5 first downs on the drive, and the handoff is to Corey Sheets. Stacked up and brought down Juwan Simpson there to prevent him from getting to pay dirt.
Well, Calgary steps up this time. Juwan Simpson's got to be the leader here and get those guys in the interior rally. They got a little push now, that Saskatchewan O-line. So Juwan Simpson steps up, makes a play down on the goal line.
Riders stop the Stampeders inside the 10. Now the Stampeders trying to do likewise and turn away the Roughriders. Play of the drive, upcoming. Second and goal from the 3. Durant, end zone, touchdown! Rob Pegg has the major score.
Look at
Just a three-step drop from the shotgun. Lots of space created as Rob Bagg runs a nice route in front of the corner, Fred Bennett.
Second playoff touchdown for the Queens product, Rob Bagg, one of the comeback stories of 2013. So an aggressive drive as the Rough Riders get traction on their third possession of the game. And they have the lead here in the Western Final.
Fred Bennett's had a good year at corner, but he gives Rob Bagg a lot of room here. It's a secondary that's been underrated. And look at the room that Fred Bennett is going to give Rob Bagg at the outside wide receiver position. He's just going to run that quick slant in, steps up. Look at that. 6-7 yards of room up front. Now, does Darian Duran have a nice throwing lane? Take a look at this group again. Any penetration from the inside could disrupt this play. Darian Duran has lots of time. Great throwing lane. No one in his face.
Eight plays, 75 yards. The length of the scoring drive for Darian Duran. After punts on their opening two possessions.
After that drive, I would say defensive coordinator Rick Campbell may have to go with some more pressure, start to send some linebackers, give that defensive line a little bit help to try and contain the run and Durant.
Schmidt with the kickoff. Fielded by Taylor at the 18-yard line. Both teams have been outstanding on cover this year. And Mike McCullough makes the tackle. John Cornish has to go back to find the helmet. You need that. Now he's ready for duty with just over 2.5 minutes left here in the opening quarter. Just two carries for 3 yards for Cornish. Corey Sheets slow on his first two possessions, but a big part of that touchdown drive. Mentioned Cornish with three consecutive 100-yard playoff games. Lavelle Coleman has the Calgary record with four. Big to Cornish, and it's way deep downfield, and the ball is caught by Joe West. West with the catch, working against the corner by Williams. And it's a 46-yard strike.
Joe West has had limited action as a Calgary Stampeder. But he started the season, played the first four games, and seems to like to play against the Saskatchewan Roughriders. His very first play in the CFL against Saskatchewan was a year ago. It was a touchdown catch inside post route on Rod Williams.
Injured in week four, put on the 9-game disabled list, and then re-injured in week 15. Here's Cornish. And he is surrounded in the backfield and drilled back at the 35. Jermaine McElvain's in the middle of it again.
Yeah, he's there to make the tackle. John Chick forced the play. Big number 97 just takes his pass rush, reestablishes the line of scrimmage. Watch him crash in here and not give John Cornish any options. He's not allowed to get started. When Cornish is at his best, it's when he gets a little downhill speed. But the penetration from John Chick up the field, steps in front of Cornish, cuts him off, and now he's scrambled.
Now four rushes for minus 6 yards. John Cornish, the Western nominee for MOP and top Canadian. Kevin Glenn. Here's Jabari Arthur down at the 24-yard line, and he'll be short of the first down.
You know, Kevin Glenn was named the starter by John Huffnagel right after the semifinal weekend was complete, as the Calgary Stampeders had the bye to the final and were waiting to see who they'd face. He said, Kevin Glenn's the starter. He's earned the right. But if Kevin Glenn isn't seeing it as this game goes on, John Huffnagel could pull the trigger and we could see Drew Tate. But a nice throw to Joe West by Glenn on that series.
Ronnie Paredes, 54 of 57 in the regular season. The Western All-Star drills from 31 yards up. And it's the Rough Riders leading 7-6.
Yeah.
Eagles. Touchdown pass for Darian Durant in this game tonight in the Western Final. And this year, a personal best for Durant as we take a look at the touchdown passes by the top quarterbacks in that category in the league. Henry Burris with 24 and Darian Durant, personal best 31.
Last year here at McMahon, in the Western Semi, four touchdown passes, 435 yards, and it wasn't enough. 258, 278, 202, the totals for Durant in the regular season against Calgary. Stampeders 1, 2, and 3. Corey Sheets off and running off the left side, and at the 40-yard line, he opens this possession with a 5-yard run. Final play, opening quarter. The visiting Roughriders with a 1-point lead.
That dog is mine.
There are the numbers after 15 minutes of football in the Western Final.
Calgary Stampeders got good field position when Brandon Smith took that punt down inside the 20-yard line. Got a couple field goals out of that first quarter. One real good drive by Saskatchewan where we noticed that the offensive line play by the Riders and that the backups that are playing for the Calgary Stampeders is going to be an issue. We're watching that as this game goes on.
War in the trenches. Both teams lost starting defensive tackles, but the replacement for the Roughriders, McIlvain's been a little more prominent.
Well, he's got more experience, especially in playoff games. I mentioned that he's played for the Montreal Alouettes, played in three great cups in 08, 09, and 10. And right now, yeah, he's playing well, replacing Terrius George. On the other hand, Etienne Legare and Junior Turner are struggling a little bit on the interior of the Calgary defensive line.
And that rushing total for the Stampeders and eye-opener, minus 6 in the first 15 minutes. Snap the second quarter. Roughriders at the 42nd and 5. Tosh Smith has the catch and has the first down. Got drilled out by the corner, Chris Randall, but it's an 8-yard pickup for 88.
300-yard games in the regular season for Tosh Smith, one of 3,000-yard receivers for the Saskatchewan Roughriders in 2013.
And the leader in receptions was 78. Double tight end formation. Sheets takes the handoff, tries to spin off, and does. Gets flushed back in by Mayo. And at the 51-yard line, he's dropped close to 4 for Corey Sheets.
George Cortez is going with a little tight end formation, and I'm not surprised at all because here's what it'll do. It'll take the two stars on the defensive line and put them wider on the line of scrimmage. Charleston Hughes will have to widen out to go play over the tight end, and so will Kodera Locke. That isolates the interior a little bit more for the interior of the O-line of Saskatchewan.
Sheets, 7 carries, 39 yards so far. Second and 6. Here comes Heat. And Durant decked up right now. He'll dump it off. Sanders has some blocking into Calgary territory. A drop to the 49. It's a first down as Darian Durant shows you his escapability.
Had a great conversation with Juwan Simpson about trying to tackle Darian Durant. And they said, you know, sometimes you hear defensive players talk about quarterbacks being like running backs in the backfield. They're so strong in the lower body. Well, Darian Durant, they said, is more like a fullback. He's so strong. He just basically breaks the tackle to get that play done.
Ends up being a 9-yard pickup for the first down. And here's Sanders off the right side. Another good run. Charleston Hughes will drop him at the 42, but it's 7 more on the run. Good first down production, something Darian Durant was emphasizing to us yesterday.
Brendan Labatt is a finalist for outstanding nominee for the outstanding offensive lineman. And watch how he pulls out and just eats up that second level, getting on Juwan Simpson.
Jamar Wall checks in for the Calgary defense as Keon Raymond goes to the sidelines. Second and 3. It'll be Sheets. And it'll be another Roughrider first down to the 36. So the big boys up front are opening things up for Corey Sheets.
Dominic Picard's turn along with Chris Best. They're both going to drive out after the snap of the football and watch the space they create for Corey Sheets. That time it's Eric Fraser. He came down from his safety spot to try and help out in the box and got blown out of there.
Riders average 125 yards rushing in their three games against Calgary. Got seven there. First down. And Durant. Downfield, and he was looking for Getzlaff, who can't hang on. And Jamar Wall was there defensively.
Take a look at what the Saskatchewan Roughriders may go back to here as you watch this. There is no safety in the middle because play after play, Calgary is starting to bring Eric Fraser down. That can open up for Darian Durant. A deep post route if he elects to go there. Now this time it goes on the out to Chris Getzlaff, and he drops football. Good play made there by Jamar Wall.
Second and 10 from the 35. Time. Pass is complete, and it should be a first down for G. Roy Simon. His first catch is a Roughrider in a Western Final. This is his 10th Western Final.
He gets this catch because Chris Getzlaff. Chris is going to step up. He sees the safety down low once more, makes the key block so that Durant can wait for G. Roy Simon to his right to run the curl. Opens up, hits him right in the chest.
Looking for his first victory on the road in a Western Final. Joe Eric back up and back inside, and again, they are really slashing through that Calgary front. Corey Sheets with another terrific run. 9 on first down that time.
Dan Clark in at the tight end spot. Corey Sheets taking that handoff to the right of Darian Durant, and look at the cutback lane that he finds. It's from that left side. Brendan Labatt opens a nice hole for him with Xavier Fulton.
In three games, he had 47 first half rushing yards against Calgary. He has 61 already. Now it's Jack Sanders' turn on second and short. And the chains are moving for the Riders again.
A bit more Jock Sanders that we've seen in the backfield, and with Corey Sheets. Take a look at this game so far. His average is 6.1. No running game to speak of for the Calgary Stampeders so far.
The 11th play of the drive. It's first and goal from the 9. Sanders in. Little stutter step there, brought down by Junior Turner. The Bishop product, who was on the 9-game disabled list for the first half of the season and now in the fire in the absence of Bolden and Johnson.
Yeah, he's got 46 regular season games under his belt. This time, Junior Turner makes a nice play for Rick Campbell, defensive line, to get a stop. He's got to use his speed more than a DeMonte Bolden, who outweighs him by about 30 pounds.
Sheets back in. Simon motion, so does Dressler. And gets left to the right side. That's where he's looking. Into the end zone. Touchdown. Another touchdown for Chris Getzlaff against the Stampeders. Well, you heard from Lee Jones. That's his 12th career touchdown against Calgary.
I truly believe, Chris, that whether they're running the football or throwing it, Darian Durant feels real comfortable right now because of the play of the offensive line. They're winning that war in the trenches, allowing him to run this offense.
Seven touchdowns in the regular season. Coming back off injury and into the end zone as the Roughriders increase their lead.
No question that the divisional all-star and Chris Getzlaff can make breaks with that knee brace on. Watch how he turns Eric Fraser here, the safety, all the way around. Fraser takes a peek and wants to widen to this drop in the curl right here, and Getzlaff just spins inside, knee brace and all, wide open. The second touchdown throw of the game from Darian Durant.
12 plays, 75 yards in just over 6 minutes for the Roughriders. Gets off with 11 touchdowns in the regular season, his third in the postseason against Calgary. So 14 touchdowns against the Stampeders. Diamond Ferry on the kick return tackle. 14-6. Roughriders here in the second quarter.
And now south to the land of the pines, I'm thumbing my way to North Carolina, staring up the road.
Stamps with some insider technology to deal with the minus temperatures. With more, here's Farhan Lalji.
Yeah, Chris, it is cold here, and the Stampeders have a bit of an edge in terms of how they're dealing with it. We'll start with these hand warmers. Now, they look just like the ones the Stamps are wearing, but black. But actually, there's a battery inside this, and it is fully heated throughout. Much better than what the Riders are using with just their hand warmers inside of it. Also, as far as Kevin Glenn is concerned, he is using this glove on his left hand. It also has a battery on the back of it, so it is very warm on his right hand. He's wearing a regular receiver's glove, and he's never done that before in a cold weather game. Seems to have worked right there with that completion.
It did indeed, as he hooked up with Jeff Fuller, but Fuller put the ball on the carpet. And who's got the football? It's Saskatchewan football as they turn it over once again. And out of the pile comes Terrell Mays. There is a flag down. Fuller with three regular season starts, and they talked about winning mismatches. He went up to get that, but when he came down, he lost the handle.
It's a late flag, well after the play was over.
On the play, we have a change of possession, Saskatchewan ball. Following the play, we have a major foul, unnecessary roughness, 92, Saskatchewan. 15-yard penalty, first down.
So Zach Evans called, but after the takeaway of the fumble lost by Jeff Fuller.
Well, Jeff Fuller out of Texas A&M, first of all, does such a nice job to win the jump ball here. I mean, he goes up over Tristan Jackson to get it. Jackson doesn't give up, however, fights for it and end up ripping it out of the hands of Fuller as they go to the ground right there. Just got a piece of it.
They take over on their own 16-yard line and answer two Calgary field goals with two touchdown flags. And then the pull sheet stacked up, but Junior Turner says enough's enough. And it's a 2-yard sheet gain.
Junior Turner stepping up now and starting to use his speed a little bit in the interior here. He's getting the double team, works off it, and steps into Corey Sheets to say, I'm not done yet.
Saskatchewan won the turnover battle head-to-head, 6-4 in the regular season, but not many points scored off turnovers by either team. Here's Durant looking for Dressler, comes up with it. He gets tossed down, flagged down on the play as the tackle's made by the speedy Darius Brooks. A bumping in the flat between those two.
Dressler really had to fight for that football, came back to get it. See what this flag is.
What a Western semi he had last year with 6 catches, 153
pass
yards.
Calgary, number 32. The penalty is declined. First down.
So Brooks, the pass interference call is declined. Bumping with Dressler, who had a couple of touchdowns last week.
Out there on the corner, first game, Darius Brooks now working on Dressler, who they move outside Saskatchewan. He runs that curl, starts to come back, and a little ground to run on it.
16-yard play, first down. Roughriders 34. Sheets trying to kick it outside. Cordero Long pursuit, and Corey Sheets is rumbling here in the opening half, 14 more.
Well, there's two things. One for the Calgary Stampeders. John Huffnagel's got to talk to his troops at halftime about a little bit more ball security. You see him shaking his head there a little bit. They've given up the ball a couple times on turnovers after big plays like the Jeff Fuller catch for Saskatchewan and Corey Chamberlain. It's about some of those late penalties for late hits. Those can come back and haunt you in a game like this.
And Sheets again takes off. And he hits midfield. So Corey Sheets, before that carry, 77 yards in his opening half. Nine 100-yard games in the regular season. He has 84 on the day.
Corey Sheets is getting a chance to bounce most of these runs. It's one of the things that he loves to do is that shuffle step at the line of scrimmage and bounce outside.
And it's a sign that the field conditions are good here. Yesterday, he might not have been able to bounce it around as much. And here's Sanders, so it's been a 1-2 running punch. Jock Sanders.
Well, we another first down showed run. You earlier that John Cornish finished second all-time against Calgary Stampeder running backs. How about Corey Sheets here? 1,598 yards rushing. That was just behind George Reed's 1965 campaign at 1,768. So second all-time this year for Sheets.
Talked a lot about the rivalry between the two running backs. He doesn't want John Cornish in his locker next week. Here Durant now stepping up. And he'll slide at the 45. He got drilled. Ball came loose. Stampeders say they haven't. And Darian Durant was headed down, and now he's slow to get up.
Looked like it was Sean Lemon. Stepped into Durant, and he's hurt. Durant took an extra step. Didn't declare early on the hook slide.
He got a pretty good shot on the helmet here from Levin.
No question, helmet to helmet contact. I think that's what Durant was looking towards the official.
But when a player, and we've talked a lot about helmet to helmet, when a player is surrendering himself like that, it's hard to call helmet to helmet because the target's moving. Durant's still appealing here.
Well, he's going down, so obviously the target area changes for Sean Lemon, but Durant has to declare earlier if he doesn't want to be hit at all.
Now he wants a play from the sidelines. Under 5 minutes left. Here in the first half, looking at second and nine. Pressure on, stands in, and tight coverage there again. That battle between Brooks and Dressler draws another flag.
Big flag. Now Darius Brooks is indicating that it's going against Saskatchewan.
This time it was Dressler with his hands on Brooks from the official's point of view.
Pass interference, Saskatchewan, number 7. Penalty is declined, third down.
It's time they move Weston Dressler into the slot back position where he normally plays, and Darius Brooks comes with them. So a matchup where they're trying to go one-on-one, Brooks on Dressler. We've seen a couple routes run by these two already. Called out on Dressler, said he grabbed Brooks on the turn.
Well, it was a tough first quarter for Ricky Schmidt. 25, 22-yard punts with the wind at his back. He'll sail this one into the end zone. And it will go through for a single point. It's a 65-yard single for Schmidt. And it's a 9-point Saskatchewan lead. One of the most popular shows of all time celebrates its 50th anniversary with an epic all-new special. Don't miss Doctor Who, The Day of the Doctor, Saturday at 2:50 Eastern, exclusively on Space. That time of possession was huge in the Eastern Final, dominated that category by the winning Hamilton Ticats. Roughriders have an edge here in the first half.
Oh, we got it.
Just over 4 minutes to go. Here at the Reese Price. Price stand up. And he'll get caught and stripped by Tristan Jackson. Wild Williams gets it back. The third time that the Stampeders have turned it over in this opening half. What a play by Tristan Jackson. Shades of Fred Bennett earlier this season.
Absolutely. Just never quits on the play. And Tristan Jackson turns this around. A big play made again, and it's not Kevin Glenn's fault here. I mean, Kevin Glenn hits Maurice Price in stride over the middle on a nice slant route in behind the linebacking core as they flow to John Cornish. But Maurice Price, lots of room. Watch Tristan Jackson come from right to left, strip the football, bounces right up to Rod Williams.
Unnecessary roughness. Calgary, number 9, 15 yards at the end of the play. First down, Saskatchewan.
So Cornish adds to the problems for the Stampeders with the 15-yard penalty, and then marches it back into Calgary territory. Ball security. I think that'll be a focus of discussion for John Huffnagel in the Calgary locker room at halftime. Better believe it. That's the second big play. One made by Joe West, who fumbled. And then Maurice Price. And that was a takeaway by Tristan Jackson.
Roughriders take over Calgary 42-yard line. Durant, Todd Schmidt. Hit as he caught the football and finally dragged down. Tackle made by Chris Randall. 5-yard pickup.
I mentioned Joe West, actually Jeff Fuller on the first one. A big play made by Calgary. Kevin Glenn with a nice throw over the top. Fuller loses the handle. Saskatchewan recovers. Now it's Maurice Price. Good yards after the catch, and that's a takeaway. Tristan Jackson slams the football under there.
Fortuitous hop right into the hands of Williams. Second and 5. Going to take a shot, looking downfield. What's the football? Touchdown! Matched up against Darius Brooks, wins that battle. A 37-yard touchdown strike, and Durant has 3 touchdown passes in the first half.
Right body control by Weston Dressler. Ball thrown to his outside shoulder. Darian Durant wants to throw Dressler open here. Throw it to the outside. Darius Brooks on his inside shoulder. And Dressler does the rest.
Third playoff touchdown of 2013 for Weston Dressler. Led the Rough Riders with 9 touchdown catches in the regular season. And an enormous first half here for the Rough Riders.
Take a look again at the body control by Weston Dressler, and Darian Durant throwing his receiver open. Darius Brooks is going to take away the inside shoulder. He wants inside leverage here. Now, as Darian Durant sees that, he's going to throw it to the outside and hope that Weston Dressler can make the reaction as the ball is in the air at the top of the rope. Good body control, turns back outside. Touchdown, Saskatchewan.
Larry Taylor on the return. Get across the 30-yard line. The Stampeders have had the ball for 1:17 of this second quarter.
Throughout the regular season, Corey Sheets has been at times criticized for his inability to be able to make a block on in the passing game. And watch him step up and take out Jawan Simpson right down Main Street. And when he does that, that gives Durant a second to throw the football right where he wants to put it so that Dressler can adjust his run.
6 possessions here in the first half for Calgary. An interception, 2 fumbles, 8 points off turnovers, and Cornish spilled at the 35-yard line. It has 3.
Calgary Stampeders have to talk ball security at halftime and also how they're going to get John Cornish more involved in this offense in the second half. Just 4 carries for John Cornish and just 2 yards in basically half the football. Guy who averaged over 100 yards per game in the regular season.
2nd and 7, Stampeders. Run 5-for-8 in this first half. Maurice Price, another catch. And he's got a first down up at the 48-yard line.
Maurice Price. Talk about ball security. He caught this slant similar to the last big play he made where it was stripped from Tristan Jackson. Watch him hold the football when he feels contact approaching from Diamond Ferry, cover it up with two arms and go down with it.
Didn't have a 30-plus play against Saskatchewan the regular season, a couple of years, but fumbles at the end. Play action fake, they want a big one here, jump ball again, and incomplete. But that was Joe West up against Tristan Jackson.
I think that was just Kevin Glenn wanting to see if his receiver could make a play.
No replacement.
You know, Maurice Price, as I mentioned, replacing Marquay McDaniel, and one of the reasons that John Cornish may not be having a big first half is the blocking that he usually got from Marquay McDaniel and Nick Lewis when he was in the lineup early in the year.
Well, it's interesting because the Lions did have some run success against Calgary last week, or against Saskatchewan last week. Second and 10, under 2 minutes left here in the second quarter. Glenn on a roll and unable to connect with Maurice Price there. So the punt team has to come on again.
A good discussion about a week ago about his Dave Dickinson and John Huffnagel about his quarterback situation, and they've got such a good one here in Calgary with three that have won games. He said, you know, we're not going to pull the quarterback if we're behind in a game if it's not the quarterback's fault. And Kevin Glenn in this first half has thrown some nice footballs down the field, made some big plays down the field, and receivers have just put it on the turf.
All-star punter Rob Maber out of Guelph in for his second punt. Last time he faced Saskatchewan, averaged 49.4 yards. This into that breeze and a decent kick. Sanders from the 20. And Yannick Carter will force him out of bounds. We've got 1:37 remaining here in the opening half. The marquee guys are on site here at McMahon, and we'll check in with them. GMC live at the half on what has been a dominant performance by the Rough Riders in the opening 30 minutes so far. The Ticats in the Eastern Final. So will it be Hamilton and Calgary, the teams that dueled in 98 and 99 and split those games, or Hamilton and Saskatchewan, 71 and 89, Grey Cup combatants. 29-yard line, and Corey Sheets again gets it inside. Pulled down at the 34-yard line. Another tackle made by Chris Randall.
You know, I mentioned off the top, Darian Durant's only lost one playoff game that last year against Calgary, and in that game he threw for over 400 yards and four touchdowns. He's put together very good games in the playoffs. When you look at Western Finals against the Calgary Stampeders, he's 2-0.
Rough Riders can't put together a better recipe than Durant hitting with three touchdown passes in the first half, and Corey Sheets approaching 100 yards rushing. Pressure on there, and the pass for Dressler is incomplete. And it will be third down, and the Stamps will get the football back one more time here in this opening half to close the gap.
Get a little bit of pressure that time. That's been why Saskatchewan has dominated time of possession this first half, because of the lack of pressure. But that time, they got some push off the edge from Cordero Law and Charleston Hughes. What a play by Ricky Schmidt. You're right. A couple of tough punts early on. One that just went 22 yards, turned into a big return for Calgary in the first quarter. This ball looked like it was well over his head. He knocks it down and quickly reloads and gets it out of there.
Levi Steinauer, the long snapper. And Milo over to congratulate Schmidt on that recovery. But it's Calgary with the football at the 46, down by 15, and 61 seconds on the clock for Kevin Glenn.
of the first half. And look for Weston. It's intercepted. Another turnover. Terrell Mays has the interception. Just one in the regular season, but Mays with a huge one here. Four turnovers in the first half for Calgary.
Well, the two on the deep throws weren't Kevin Glenn's fault. This one, it looks like he just didn't see coverage dropping underneath it and tried to throw the football through the defender.
Well, that will certainly make you wonder who comes up to start the ball.
I was going to say, I mean, the first two, not necessarily his fault. He did in that first interception throw the first pick to Jermaine McElvain on a screen play. That was a decision by Glenn, that last play.
Had turnover problems on October 26th. Drew Tate came in and won the game. Here's Dressler. Has a first down into Stamps territory. And he'll get dragged out at the 48 as they try to rip it out. But Weston Dressler hangs on to the football.
Darian Durant focused with George Cortez calling a nice mix of run and pass. First downs right now dominating Calgary Stampeders. Saskatchewan with 18-2, and Rick Campbell may have to send more pressure.
Nobody saw that coming, that kind of domination. Josh Smith off the shoe tops, gets away, and he has another first down. Nifty piece of work there for Taj Smith. And a half minute left on the clock. A 13-yard gain for the Rough Rider wideout.
And about a first down play as Darian Durant tries to call this on the line of scrimmage. But the first down play with the extra effort from Taj Smith. And they're in chip shot field goal range for Chris Mueller.
5 catches, 51 yards for Smith in this opening half. Durant under pressure, gets it away. Kiroy Sale was wide open and has the catch. Durant ushers him out of bounds. Clock stop, 13 seconds remaining. 19 for number 81.
The mobility of Darian Durant, first off, he feels a little bit of pressure. Calmly will bounce off, first retreat a little bit, then he bounces outside, and of course G-Roy Simon looking for that hole, and Durant with his eyes down the field as he gets outside of containment, throw and catch to number 81.
Double tight end, see how many plays they can squeeze in. Has some, lots of time, crosser, caught, and it's dropped in the end zone. Picked up by Jamar Wall. Scott McHenry with the fumble, and away goes Wall. Down the sidelines and pushed up by Corey Sheets. And what a big takeaway that is for the Calgary Stampeders defense.
Scott McHenry, was he down as he closed to the goal line? No, it looked to me like that ball came out just before his knee touched. That's a fumble and recovery by the Calgary Stampeders.
Well, that's an enormous play to take points off the board for Saskatchewan. And no time left on the clock. They are still discussing whether or not any penalties on the play. End of the first half, Western final, Rough Riders lead. Have not officially over yet. The Rough Riders have challenged that last play. We've seen replays of the McHenry fumble.
The ruling on the field has been confirmed by replay. It was a fumble across the goal line. It's halftime.
As we thought, one more look just to confirm. Missed opportunity for Durant in a brilliant first half. But the helmet of Keon Raymond knocked the ball out. Largest first half deficit that the Calgary Stampeders have faced this year as they trail 22-6. Headed to the third quarter of the Western Final. First to the sidelines. Here's Fire and Lodgy with John Hupnagle.
John, turnovers have not been an issue for your team all season. They were in that first half. What did you say to your team about it?
Well, I mean, we're going into the game thinking we've got to minimize the turnovers. The thing about these turnovers are after big plays that we made, you know, took yards off the field, on field position, and gave them the ball. Between the turnovers, our missed tackles, we got to straighten those things out.
Last time you played Saskatchewan, a lot was on the line. In the second half, you went with Drew Tate. Can we expect to see you do that again here?
I would think you would.
Thanks, John.
Well, we got the scoop that we were anticipating. It will be Drew Tate to come in to start the second half.
Well, the quarterback on the panel nailed it at halftime when he said that he wouldn't be surprised at all to see Calgary Stampeders switch it up, put Drew Tate in the game. He does have success. Remember back to last year's Western semifinal when Drew Tate found a way to win for Calgary.
Stampeders 3-2 when trailing at the half this year, but never by more than five until this game, and a big hit by Mike McCullough on the kick cover. And it will be Drew Tate to come out to start the second half. And again, he came in relief on October 26th and was the hero in the Western semi last year with that miraculous final minute touchdown to win.
Back to Rombie Bryant, over 60-yarder. Drew Tate starts the second half.
30 of 41, 412 yards, two touchdowns, no interceptions. Up against Saskatchewan this year. They start at the 38, and they'll put the ball in the hands of John Cornish. And Cornish up near the 45-yard line on his first carry of the second half.
Now, in fairness to Kevin Glenn, a couple of big plays that he made nice throws on. One to Mo Price for 57 yards was a fumble after the catch, and one to Fuller for 46 also fumbled. Those weren't his fault, but a couple of interceptions. Not good decisions by Kevin Glenn.
Head-to-head, just 10 yards fewer than Darian Durant threw for. But the two interceptions, and as you mentioned, two big plays, negated by fumbles at the end. Seven for Cornish, who had one in the first half. Second and three, John Cornish. Second level for the first time this year, or in this game, at a first down.
And a good start for Calgary offensively to come back. And Rob Cote is going to get the key block. He's going to line up at tight end. So looks like Dave Dickinson's going back to John Cornish, trying to get him established here, and maybe with a little tight end formation of his own. And Rob Cote is such a great blocker when he comes in to help out Cornish.
Four turnovers in the first half, the most Calgary's had this year, but for one game, that was the last game against Saskatchewan. Five turnovers in that game, but they survived to win it. Here's Durant just dipping it off, and Bradson not playing on the run. He's stripped of the football, and it's going to be Saskatchewan ball again. Tyron Brackenridge, and it's the fifth turnover for Calgary in 32 minutes.
Weldon Brown was in chase on Brad Sinopoli, and I'm not sure if he punches it out or Sinopoli just puts this one on the turf by himself, but Nick at 35 with the great hustle from behind, and it is that right arm punching from underneath the football on Sinopoli. It pops out of there. Tyron Brackenridge with the recovery.
Roughriders second best in takeaways during the regular season, their second highest total in 17 years when they created 53 turnovers. And they get the ball right back to start the second half at their 30-yard line. Here's Sheets, a little sidestep, and not much there.
Well, let's take a look at the first half. Issues for the Calgary Stampeders with ball security. A couple of fumbles, one recovered by Maurice Price himself. Now this is where Fuller put one on the ground. Recovered by Saskatchewan. Maurice Price had a big play. That was the 57-yarder that Ron Williams picked up off the fumble. And then the poor decision by Kevin Glenn on his second interception. We see Drew Tate and a fumble to start this second half by Sinopoli.
Four turnovers and five possessions for Calgary. After a couple of field goals, they're going to screen this, and it's Sanders getting it outside. inside. Deron Mayo recovers and makes the tackle. And a 2-and-out to start the second half for the Rough Riders on offense.
Was it just me, or did it look like Jock Sanders there? He tried to get outside, was trying to chop his feet a little bit. The footing may be getting a little bit slipperier as the sun sets here in Calgary. Wasn't a factor in the first half.
The guy's talking about the short turf here. Not very thick, the carpet. And can cause more footing problems than the more modern carpet. Taylor, that's great special teams cover. Downfield, Diamond Ferry. Paul Waldo, and Waldo, who led the Rough Riders with 21 special team tackles. Can Drew Tate rally the Stamps back?
Jumbo!
This Saturday, it's the warm-up to the biggest party of the year. Great Cup Saturday gets you set with Gibson's finest CFL Player Awards. Top 25 plays of the year features from team practices. And a lot more. It all gets underway Saturday, noon Eastern, 9 a.m. Pacific on TSN. If the Rough Riders do hold the lead, is it really going to be the biggest party of the year? Or is that the biggest understatement of the year? John Cornish trying to change the direction of this game. Good run on first down across midfield. And nine for number nine.
Show you a little adjustment here at halftime by Dave Dickinson. They have moved now Rob Cote, the fullback, into a slot back spot where Maurice Price played in the first half. The reason they're bringing him in there is to get some blocking in front of John Cornish and get that running game going.
Now, Cornish has to take a page out of Corey Sheets' playbook, and it'd be huge in the second half after being a slow starter. Tate with a good surge there behind the offensive line to get a fresh set of downs.
Yeah, it really mirrors the season as well, where Corey Sheets got off to such a great start in the rushing derby, and then John Cornish just quietly bided his time and had such a strong finish to lead the way.
3 first downs for the Stamps here in the third quarter, only 3 in the first half. First down, Rough Rider 51-yard line. And they'll hitch it to Price. Maurice Price will get pushed out by Rod Williams at the 46, and it's a gain of 5. 3 big plays in that first half. Price involved in a couple of them, but a fumble by Price, a fumble by Fuller, to negate those big plays, something they weren't able to generate in the regular season against Saskatchewan. So 2nd and 5. Brett Jones, the all-star rookie center, over the football. Tate with a pop, he's got a wide open man. Joe Walsh behind everybody. It's a Calgary touchdown. And the Stamps are back in it.
Drew Tate sets this play up with a couple of hitch passes. A little bit of running game from John Cornish. Hitch pass to Maurice Price. And now he's got the Saskatchewan secondary starting to creep towards the line of scrimmage. And all three get sucked up on Larry Taylor and allow Joe West in behind coverage. Easy throw and catch from Drew Tate. Calgary Stampeders right back in it.
Well, a bust there exposed. A 46-yard touchdown. A 4-play, 63-yard touchdown drive. West, who played sparingly this year because of the shoulder injury. 3 touchdowns. Big one here. Drew Tate now at the controls, trying to engineer a comeback.
Straight buzz by the Saskatchewan secondary. It's supposed to be a 1-2-3 deep zone coverage by Saskatchewan. They got to have one between Rod Williams and the halfback Dwight Anderson. Go back into that outside third. Both of them get sucked up and jump Larry Taylor in the flat. When they do that, Joe West gets in behind coverage. Touchdown Calgary.
West, 3 catches, 101 yards. Trying to give Calgary life
from the 9. Hurdles his way over the 30 and up to the 34-yard line.
I love you, Mom. I love you. You know I'm not here. I'm working. I'm having fun. I'm loving life.
A little message to Mom there from Joe West. Probably couldn't believe his eyes when he turned around and said, wait a minute, there's no deep third here player here. All he had to do was make the catch. Nice throw by Drew Tate. Sometimes quarterbacks will try and aim that, miss a wide open target. He just put it right in his hands. Calgary right back in this game.
Touchdown in the regular season against the Roughriders. Big one to get them off life support here. During the ramp wants to win it through with a shot looking for Drexler. And did he make the catch? They're going to mark him at the 40. What a spectacular grab.
Unbelievable catch by Drexler. Just a subtle little push. It looked like he hurt himself on the way down.
Well, that would be a cause for concern, but a 36-yard grab that flips the field in a hurry.
Darian Durant up over the top to the outside shoulder. A little bit of a subtle push on Darius Brooks. Boy, we've watched this matchup in the first half between these two. 32-7. Drexler has a first down, or first half touchdown.
Just got the tap in, and the challenge flag does come out. It's a close play on the sideline. Certainly close enough you anticipated, but John Updegel might want them to take a closer look.
Chris, I saw that tap as well, but was the tap just before he had possession of the football, I think, is what John Huffnagel wants to find out.
Calgary is challenging the ruling on a field of a completed pass. We'll review the play.
Huge challenge. As the Roughriders try to get the momentum back and would have it with this catch if it stands.
I think it looked to me like Drexler touches that right foot down before he has possession. Doesn't have it yet. Now he has possession right there. And is that
There's
foot coming
tap.
Off? There was a second tap with
second
the right
tap
foot.
Is the one that might stand. You're right. He doesn't have possession there on the first tap.
Now he does.
And right there, does he get a toe in? Probably our best look at it here. Ball in his hands, and does that right foot right there drag in?
What's making
after review? The ruling on a field has been confirmed by replay. It was a completed pass. First down.
I was going to say, Chris, what made that tougher on the review was the fact that he tapped the toe on the second time right on the white stripe, and it was white dust that flew up in the air.
And the extra good news for the Roughriders, the challenge gave him time to recover a bit from the play that he hobbled on, but that is a spectacular catch. And suddenly the Roughriders are in scoring position again. Although they are working against the breeze here in the third quarter. First down, Calgary 40. Durant is going to throw it up to Getzlaff. Sheds a tackle, first down, and down the sidelines before Simpson takes him out.
Come on now.
Wearing a brace on the injured knee, Getzlaff, who had a touchdown in the first half, has 20 on that catch.
I watched Getzlaff run in the warm-up, and it looked like he was struggling a little bit, trying to get a smooth running motion. But no problem here. As he fights off the tackle there of Darius Brooks, breaks outside, and it's Juwan Simpson in pursuit that is going to finally push him out of bounds.
First down, Stampeder, 20-yard line. Corey Sheets, a little stutter step. That's his patented move, and now gets stacked up and pushed back, and It'll be a 7-yard gain as Charleston Hughes, who's been relatively quiet so far tonight, tosses him down.
I'll show you what Charleston Hughes does here to make this tackle. Milt Stegall talked about this at halftime. Watch how much he's going to cheat down to try and help those interior defensive tackles in the run game. He cheats down inside big time to help out on Corey Sheets here. Now, does that open up an outside lane for Darian Durant to pull it?
Top defensive player in the West, number 39, looking for a stop on second and three. Durant takes a long look, and is he going to take off? No, into the end zone, Tosh Smith, and it's under. No, it's dropped. Should have been an interception for Eric Fraser, and he couldn't hang on.
Well, and Tosh Smith runs away from this rather than coming back to help out Darian Durant, and that's why the Riders are fortunate that Eric Fraser doesn't come up with an interception. Instead of fighting back this way to help Durant, who's scrambling, Tosh Smith fades away from it and allows Eric Fraser to come underneath and have a crack at this football. Really should have had the pick, actually fought with his own teammate Chris Randall.
He almost had it secured and tucked, but it came loose. It allows Milo to come onto the field for a 20-yard attempt. And it was blocked off the upright end. It'll be picked up. So the Roughriders twice now on their last two ventures into the red zone come away empty. First the McHenry fumble, and now that missed opportunity. And will it come back to haunt them?
I'm not sure if Fred Bennett coming off the edge there didn't get his hand on this kick.
A couple of flags to be sorted out.
No yards, Saskatchewan. 5-yard penalty, first down Calgary.
So Calgary football at the 10 when we come back. Still a 9-point lead. And it looked like Bennett may have got a hand on it.
Fred Bennett does get a piece of this. Watch him bend the corner here and just melt it down enough to get his hands in there and just get a piece of this kick.
And we were wondering whether the ball was dead as it hit the base, but because it bounced and then hit the base, the ball considered to be in play. Calgary wants to challenge that, I believe. John Huffnagel going to throw the flag again. And there was a long conversation during the break about whether or not that's the correct spot for the football and whether the ball off the base of the upright should be considered a dead ball, which would bring the ball up to the 25, I believe. So John Huffnagel trying to get some enhanced field position out of this.
It does clearly hit, but it does bounce. I mean, you're going to see after the block, or the partial block,
or does it?
No, it hit straight off the base of that upright.
So the officials continue to conference. Jason Maggio was talking with the Calgary staff during the break. And Murray Clark, their substitute official, also in to help out.
All field goal attempts are reviewed by the command center, whether they're good or not.
That play was reviewed and the play stands.
Okay.
You can pick up your challenge.
So it was under review by the command center, not a challenge.
Replay rules, all field goals, whether they are made or unsuccessful, are reviewable by the command center. That play was reviewed. The ruling on the field stands.
Well, they did look, take a look at it. Maybe they should take another look at it. Well, I don't think there's any question that it hits the base of the upright here. Does it bounce first or not? And it looks like it hits the Edison Hortons. Well, it starts at the 10, and John Cornish bounces it up. Look at Cornish. There's the field position they wanted. And John Cornish provides it up across the 40. And Drew Tate gets a key block on Weldon Brown. When John Cornish reverses his field, the quarterback gets out front, and the decision to make a quarterback change is paying off here for Calgary. Watch Drew Tate. Reaches to get the ball. The corners recognizes he's reversing his field. Number four gets out in front, and he's going to cut down Weldon Brown in the open field, providing a cutback lane for Cornish. He does the rest, and they're out of that hole.
31 yards. He has 47 in the game now. 19, 20 yard or more carries during the year, and three of them were against the Roughriders. Tape to throw. Under pressure, foul, and the ball falls incomplete at the feet of Joe West. Tate under pressure with Keith Schulligan in pursuit.
It's like he was stumbling a little bit on his own and just went down, almost the turf monster getting Drew Tate there. Did have a nice running lane in the middle. His first incompletion this second half.
Guy who has missed most of the season with, I guess, the most severe case of what they call golfer's elbow. Not a lot of strength in that elbow for most of the year. Returning late in the season and now in the fire. Second and 10. Going to show you his arm strength here. Looking for Sinopoli. Incomplete, and the safety, Tyron Brackenridge, was there.
The elbow is fine. It was game two of the season when Drew Tate hurt that elbow against Saskatchewan. Didn't finish that game. He's 1-1 as a starter, winning his first game of the regular season against BC. You mentioned coming in for Kevin Glenn on October 26th, and he's still limping after stumbling with that incompletion.
Wind at the back of Maver. One hop for Sanders at the 14. Good cover, Ian McCarter. First man down. It's a 9-point Saskatchewan lead with under 4.5 minutes to go here in the third quarter of the Western Final. No matter what team's on offense, there's a graduate of the Weyburn Eagles on the football field. With more, here's Lee Jones.
Yeah, thanks a lot, Chris. Brendan Labatt, the offensive guard of the Saskatchewan Roughriders, the nominee, the West nominee for most outstanding lineman. He's not the only Weyburn product that will be at the year-end award. So is Breck Jones. He is the most outstanding rookie nominee. He is the center for Calgary. That's two players from Weyburn. It's an unbelievable considering the size of that city in Saskatchewan. Talk to Brendan Labatt about that. He says you got to give a lot of credit to Weyburn's minor football program. It just started up about 10 or 12 years ago, but they've done a good job of developing him, and they taught him the right way to play football, guys.
Took the cap to Eagles high school coach Darren Abel as well. Corey Sheets straight ahead, and look at Sheets power his way to the 28-yard line, close to a first down. So Sheets with that carry behind Brendan Labatt, over 100 on the day.
Let's take a look at the Weyburn product as he gets up on Junior Turner, drives his feet along with Dominic Picard. Look at Picard also grabbing on Deron Mayo as they move that defensive interior of the defensive line back about 5-6 yards.
And
Keon Raymond's on the scene immediately. Raymond, one of four defensive players who won as rookies with John Huffnagel in 2008, Jawan Simpson, Brandon Smith, Charleston Hughes, now the veteran core of that defense, trying to get back to the cup game.
Jawan Simpson, a good conversation with him about trying to handle Corey Schutz, who, by the way, at about week four, said that Jawan Simpson was the toughest linebacker he's played against all season long.
Second and seven. For the time, looking for Ty Smith over there, and he has the catch short of the first down with Chris Randall on the corner. See what kind of spot they get and whether Corey Chamberlain could be tempted. Seventh catch of the game for Taj Smith. Well, Corey Chamberlain has a decision. And the punt team comes on quickly.
Yeah, I don't think there's much of one to make there. You at this point in a close game, you got to think field position, put your defense back on the field.
Riders working against the wind in the third quarter will have it in the fourth. Ricky Schmidt had some trouble early against the wind. Not a deep kick, but a pretty good bounce. And Taylor will skip out in front of Diamond Ferry as we check back in with Farhan Lalji.
Guys, even coming into this game, there was some feeling on the part of the Stampeders staff that Drew Tate is simply better against the Rough Riders than Kevin Glenn is. Now, Dave Dickinson says he's got a smaller package for him coming into this game. They want to get the ball out quick. They also want to move the pocket. Now, despite Tate's ability with his legs, Dickinson doesn't believe he's necessarily a great zone read runner, so they may not use that. Tate himself says his arm is not 100%, especially on the deep ball, but he's already tried two since coming into the game. They had to do some extra work on him at halftime to get that shoulder loosened up and heated in the locker room before they came out here.
Well, as he got into plays with a lot of fire, and trying to stoke the comeback fires here as the flag comes down. And
time count violation, Calgary, number 9. 5-yard penalty, remains first down.
I don't think it's Sean Carter's fault, but Drew Tate trying to keep things calm here.
Yeah, and right after he realized he didn't have the formation or motion that he wanted, he kind of looked down, had to take the time count and regroup.
Heavy six, 4-2.
One thing about Tate, we've seen it many times, he will wear his emotions on his sleeve. Here's the swing pass, and it was ripped beautifully. What a quick break on the ball from Terrell Mays to bust up that play.
Boy, he shot the gap here and almost had this hitch. Drew Tate kind of blindly threw it to the hitch, thinking that there's no way that Saskatchewan would close that quickly. But watch how he flips his shoulders around here. And number 20 had a better shot at that football than Mo Price.
So the incompletion sets up 2nd and 15. A lot of different parts in that Saskatchewan secondary during the regular season. There's a little bump in there, flare it out to Cornish. Cornish comes back, it's got a first down across the 40. Or check that back to the, back across the original line of scrimmage. So the punt team does have to come on in the final minute of this third quarter.
Yeah, it's a small thing, but those time counts or procedure calls that put you in a 1st and 15 can come back to haunt you, and there it does, where Drew Tate had to check it down to John Cornish, and he couldn't make the entire Saskatchewan defense miss.
Neighbor blast one with the wind from the 18. Sanders trying to cut back, and Cordero Law, the big defensive end, slowed him down.
Darian Durant with 3 touchdown passes in this game in the playoffs. You look at his regular season, 31 touchdowns, 125 now in his career. Kent Austin at 152 in his time in Saskatchewan. And there's the great late Ron Lancaster, one shy of 300.
Little
ground to make up if he wants to catch the great one in Lancaster. But he is creeping up on a lot of the Rider record numbers.
Ken Austin's team headed to Saskatchewan.
That's right. Congratulations to the Hamilton Tiger Cats and Ken Austin's group.
At the 27-yard line, Darian Durant, the little tip to Getzlaff. And a comeback for Getzlaff. Up over the 35-yard line. Again, good first down production by the Rough Riders in this game. And that's 8 for Getzlaff.
Getzlaff has come in to block a couple of times on the run game with Corey Sheets. And this time he comes in, fakes that he's going to block. Right there as he comes into your screen, then he shoots out to the flat. And Darian Durant gets that production on first down he's looking for.
Firing a penalty, final play, third quarter. Second and 2. Sheets. First down. So they will change ends. Rough Rider football at a 9-point lead headed to the fourth quarter in this Western final. Time of possession was a deciding factor in the first game. It's advantage Rough Riders through three quarters.
Well, the Calgary Stampeders provided spark with Drew Tate. They did have a better third quarter, got the running game going when they made the adjustment to bring in the tight end. Saskatchewan has tremendous balance in their offense right now, though. In three quarters, they've run 25 running plays, 26 passing plays.
Calgary at the edge in the third quarter. They're still down by 9, but Saskatchewan with a couple of opportunities to add points on the board late in the first half here in the third quarter. Will it come back to haunt them? It's going to be interesting.
Yeah, absolutely. And you, Drew Tate, with that spark in the Calgary offense, they got their running game established a little bit from John Cornish.
Still a 2-score game for Durant and the Rough Riders. First and 10 to start this fourth quarter at the own 40-yard line. Flag comes down. Pass out of the backfield for Sanders. And a quick tackle made by Darius Brooks. Offside Saskatchewan is the indication.
Offside Saskatchewan, number 88. The penalty is declined. It'll be second down.
Anxiously pacing the sidelines, second and 10. John Huffnagel's squad down by 9, working against the wind of the fourth quarter, and 28 of the 35 points today have been with the wind. Second and 9, pressure on, Durant steps up, they take off, and Durant up to the 48-yard line, ball popped loose after the whistle. And he'll be a yard and a half or so short of the first down.
Last time Corey Chamberlain had this decision to make, he made it in a split second, kicked the football away, and he'll do the same thing, I'm sure. Calgary Stampeders defensively rallied to this one. Looked like Durant had room to run for more than the first yard, down yardage, but Deron Mayo closed that ground in a hurry.
Durant was 61 yards rushing in the three games against Calgary, of course. The big running game last week, 97 yards, and they're going to go for it. This is third and a little more than what I think.
This surprised me.
Getsy, it's a long yard. More confidence for the big boys up front. Let's see if they can do it. Derby Sheets, and it'll be a first down, a big one for the Rough Riders, who hold on to the football and complete a little bit more of that clock.
Now, the one thing that Corey Chamberlain knows is that that interior of the offensive line, Brendan Labatt, Dominic Picard, Chris Vest, have been winning when it comes to getting the push they need on the backups in Junior Turner and Etienne Legare. So I'm sure that was part of this decision to go ahead and say, we can get a little bit of a push from the interior. Let's just put Corey Sheets in behind those guys and see if he can't get it, and he did. Last year, Corey Sheets just 19 yards in the Western semi against Calgary. Got another good run on first down here to the Stampeder 50-yard line. Did most of his damage last year with 5 catches, 77 yards. He had a couple of touchdowns in the game here at McMahon in the Western semi.
It's interesting to me, though, about that decision is Corey Chamberlain, the end of the third quarter, had the very similar situation. In fact, I think it was a little bit shorter. Now, he was more in his end of the field. I believe it was around the 40-yard line.
Just wonder if he was sensing needed to do something to get the momentum back. What a momentum shift if it went the other way. So, confusion there, but they do get it off to Sheets, who falls forward for the first down.
Yeah, that's a big play by Darian Durant. This is a difficult pivot that he has to make to quickly get it to Corey Sheets. Watch how he turns at Corey Sheets. It looked like Durant went the wrong way, and he realized immediately, spins around and gives it to Sheets in the back by almost like a behind-the-back pass.
Charleston Hughes was there, but Sheets with enough momentum to get a first set of downs at the 45. Now Sanders ducking inside, staying on his feet, and getting it down to the 36-9 for Sanders, and maybe with the spot close enough for a first down.
Chris Best, big on big right there. Dominic Picard, there's Juwan Simpson. Open up a hole here for Jock Sanders. Takes it, bounces outside. Juwan Simpson is sealed. The kick out from Chris Best. And Sanders has room to get into the second level in the secondary.
Foot injury for Best kept put him on the 9 game, and the Rough Riders were not as dominant when Chris Best was not on that offensive line. Maybe the key to the run blocking of the Saskatchewan Rough Riders. Second and less than a yard. And Sanders busts through. Kicks outside and just tripped up. He might still be running if not for that shoe top tackle from Fred Bennett.
Well, we knew it would be a storyline. The backups playing in the interior of the D-line, and Junior Turner, who has been, you could tell, fatigued as this game has gone on with very limited playing time, and he gets again. This time it's Ben Heenan. Takes him out of the call.
And just clipped the right foot of Sanders. Otherwise, he would have done more damage with the Rough Riders on the move. Junior Turner getting attention with just over 10 minutes left in Calgary. CFL playoffs on TSN are brought to you by GMC. We are professional grade. Just short of 5 minutes into the fourth quarter, Junior Turner making his way to the sidelines. One of those young defensive tackles in the spotlight in this game after the injuries to Mika Johnson and Devontae Bolden in the final regular season game. 10th play of the drive. It's a first down. Rough Riders down at the stamp. 25-yard line. High snap. Corey Sheets with another good run on first down. Close to 8 more.
Well, there has been the blocking up front with Best, Picard, and Labatt. That was Corey Sheets. Corey Sheets made this move in the backfield because Sean Lemon this time did get up the field, and Sheets made him miss. So while he's been picking up lots of yards in behind some real good blocking, you can see that Sean Lemon had a chance at him in the backfield.
Sheets had 2 games, 133 yards rushing against Calgary this year. He's 130 here. Second and 2. Go back to Sheets, and that's McHenry, who got over McHenry, better feeling after that fumble late in the first half that took points off the board.
Yes, it did. Took the 7 points off the board. Now, in fairness to Scott McHenry, his last catch before this game, as he comes through the line and out the other end, his last catch before this game was back in September against Montreal. So that was his first touch of the football that he fumbled. He got that one back and got a new set of downs.
What a drive being put together by Darian Durant. They've chewed up over 6 minutes already. And she cheats again. It's stacked up. It's like Darian Durant, the last couple of snaps, it's been about three or four in a row from the shotgun, has had some trouble. It's been a bit of an adventure. He's had to go up high for a couple. That one he caught around his midsection. And Dominic Picard, I know he must be looking forward to firing off in this run game, the amount that Saskatchewan is running the football.
Picard played all 18, excuse me, Glenn, all 18 for Brendan Labatt. Now a 13th play, trying to keep it going, second and eight. Short drop. Contain him and drop him at the five. So Bang unable to get to the first down marker.
You see where the spot is. It's just past the 5 yard line.
Had to get to the three.
It was a long yard at around midfield and Corey Chamberlain went for it. Not this time. He's going to take the points.
Looking to make it a 12 point game. Remember Milo had that short field goal attempt blocked by Fred Bennett, at least partially blocked, not officially a block. Under the hole to Pressler. And Milo puts it through. So now Calgary needs a couple of touchdowns. Midway through the fourth quarter, it's the Rough Riders leading 25-13. Our sack tally brought to you by Pure Later, tackling hunger across Canada. Check, and again, hats off to Schultze and all the people of Pure Later for the fine work they do.
Take a look at Alex Hall, Charleston Hughes, and Cordero Law's totals alone. That accounted for around 140,000 pounds of food for those three guys.
Track snap, John Cornish. Right side, Cornish running over people up near the 45-yard line. Close to a first down as he untangles with Jermaine McElvain.
Yeah, Richie Hall, the defensive coordinator for the Saskatchewan Roughriders, did a real good job in the first half of completely restricting the running ability of John Cornish. Basically took him out of the game in the first half. Now Cornish is getting a little traction here. The question is, the Calgary Stampeders running out of time, and do they need to take shots down the field now?
First down run as they mark it at the 46. Into the flat, Sinopoli drops the football. But a good year for Brad Sinopoli, making the transition to the receiver spot. But unable to hold on to that as he returns to the lineup, and here's one they needed.
Yeah, he absolutely had to have that one. He also dropped one to start this second half that was a turnover, the fifth of the game for Calgary. Coming off concussion issues, and the bye week is basically the reason he was able to get back into the lineup. Missed the last couple of games.
Second and 10. Cornish releases. Deep left that way now. Over the middle, incomplete. Looking for Sinopoli again. And it looked like Cornish was available.
Yeah, and it looked like Drew Tate stepped up and he was putting that throw on himself. He just kind of pointed to himself, went through his throwing motion after the fact.
And they're going to go for it on third and 10 with 6:14 to go. Are you surprised? It's a little early, isn't it?
I think it is. It is early. There's a lot of possessions left in 6 minutes in the Canadian Football League.
Now we got a
a timeout for Saskatchewan. They want to make sure they're ready for one of the critical plays of this fourth quarter.
Well, they were just, I think Corey Chamberlain was just assuming that John Huffnagel would punt the ball with over 6 minutes to go. On third down. And now John Huffnagel has had a chance to think about it, and guess what? Changed his mind.
Wonder if the timeout just talked John Huffnagel a little bit. Maybe there was something available, and after a regroup on that Saskatchewan defense, maybe he decided, I'm not going to try it yet. So Maver to kick it away. Sanders back at his 23. He'll just hit the turf at the 25. Darian Durant has had an outstanding Western final. Under 6 minutes to go. Riding a 12-point lead. On TSN are brought to you by Wendy's Ultimate Canadian Combo, Baconator and Poutine. Wendy's, now that's better. Will the Ultimate Canadian Combo be Hamilton, Saskatchewan, or Hamilton, Calgary?
Still lots of time. Saskatchewan won the toss to start this game and deferred. 31 of the 38 points have been scored with the win.
First and 10. Double takes. Shakes ahead, but not much. Stuffed that time. Keon Raymond, Sean Lemon.
Hasn't happened often because the war in the trenches has been won so far in this game by the interior of the Saskatchewan offensive line. It was a storyline coming in with backup junior Turner and Etienne Legare playing inside along with Freddie Bishop. 207 yards rushing by the Saskatchewan Roughriders.
Interesting story from Dave Naylor. What if it would have been Doug Brown today? Wow, that was an interesting skill. Quarterback draw, Darian Durant. The one that got them here. And he up to the 35-yard line battling. And it's going to be third and one.
Haven't seen a lot of it in this game like we did in the semifinal, but he just willed the last 3-4 yards. It was sheer will to just pick up and make it close here, because it looked like he was held about 3-4 yards short of the first down with contact there. But watch him drive those strong legs. 3 full tacklers for the Calgary Stampeders, including Juwan Simpson.
Close enough to require measurement. Looks like he's about a yard short. You mentioned those legs. The teammates like to call them tree trunks. Brother, an NFL linebacker, and he says he's got chicken legs, but those are a couple of sturdy pins that stood him in good stead in these postseason.
Yeah, well, you just cannot arm tackle Darian Durant, and usually takes more than one tackler to bring him down. There were three from Calgary on the last play. Now, Corey Chamberlain's got a full yard here.
Well, I'm surprised.
I'm surprised.
I am too.
Even with the play of the O line and the backups on the D line for Calgary, I'm surprised not kicking this away.
They use a cadence now. John Huffnick has used his time. And that is something that would be valuable for Huffnagel in the last 4 minutes with his team on offense. So at least this decision has taken a timeout away from Calgary. And now Corey Chamberlain can reassess things. And now
he's changing his mind.
I wondered if they were just going to go up to the line and try and draw Calgary offside and do it that way, but that's a risky business for the 12-point lead on your own 35-yard line. You can lose control of the game in a hurry if don't get 1 yard.
You've got to kick this football away, just like Huffnagel had to punt it on the last series.
So both teams have to trade off their second half timeouts. Big rush on, and Schmidt gets it away. It'll bounce down for Larry Taylor, who kicked it. And did Saskatchewan touch that ball last? It is Saskatchewan football.
Paul Walden,
one of the unsung heroes we mentioned earlier. Paul Waldo, a six-year veteran, a Saskatchewan native, 21 special team tackles, and he was flying down the field, and Larry Taylor mishandles it.
Hits the ground, starts to bounce around. Larry Taylor, it looked like it hit his leg as he tries to get in and recover that football. It bounces off the hands, hits his right leg, and there's the last to touch it, Paul Waldo.
Diamond Ferry with the pressure, Waldo with the touch out, and huge special teams play. Another turnover by Calgary. Corey Sheets stacked up. So that's six turnovers in the game by the Stampeders. And now under 4 minutes to go, Darian Durant.
Huffnagel wants a timeout.
He wants to take as much off the clock as he can. And they do take their
timeout.
Other timeout.
Calgary.
But that really puts the Rough Riders in the driver's seat now. 12-point lead. They're in scoring range once again.
Frustration shown there from John Huffnagel. He tried to call a timeout about 10, 15 seconds before it was actually called.
You know, we have the opportunity to hear the coaches address the teams almost weekly. John Huffnagel always has a similar message about not making mistakes in the fourth quarter, finding ways to win the game. In fact, he always ends with win the game. And his team won 14 of 18 regular season games because they didn't beat themselves and they found a way. It's surprising to see them self-destruct here through 56 minutes today. Second and 10. Durant going to take a shot into the end zone. Incomplete. Dressler working against Brooks again.
First half touchdown catch from Weston Dressler was the exact same play. Get him isolated one-on-one. It's been a matchup we've watched all game long between him and Darius Brooks. That time the ball just thrown a little bit too far outside and Dressler couldn't run underneath it.
So Milo out looking for a field goal that would make it two touchdowns and at least one two-point convert.
This is nowhere near in these conditions a chip shot for Chris Milo.
He mentioned last week on a frozen field, sometimes it's like kicking a helmet.
Larry Taylor's back there to return it if he misses.
39 yards out. And Chris Milo has nailed it. Clutch kick for Milo. And the Riders get a little closer to a berth in the Grey Cup. 3 minute warning given to the benches. 28-13 Saskatchewan. Here at McMahon. Next Sunday, the Ticats kick off against the winner of this game in the 101st Grey Cup. Extended pregame coverage begins at 1 Eastern, 10 a.m. Pacific, and at 6 Eastern, 3 Pacific. It's countdown to the kickoff. Live coverage of the 101st Grey Cup gets underway here on TSN. These fans hoping to be cheering on the home team. Next week at Mosaic, Drew T. trying to rally his team back. Takes off here, takes a hit, and is dropped by Diamond Ferry at the 40-yard line. Well, he pulled off the miracle comeback last year in the Western Semi, needing a last-minute touchdown, but he needs two and a little bit more than that here with just under 3 minutes to go.
Targets Jeff Fuller, Joe West have been the guys with Maurice Price. He's trying to push the ball down the field to second and four.
battles it down and out. Unloads for Price, and he is drilled right at the point of contact. That's Rod Williams, just his third game on the corner, as he was signed in season and suffered an arm injury. You still see the wrap on the right forearm.
But has playoff game experience. Three with the Edmonton Eskimos, a former Eskimo.
And something that they felt they were missing last year when they lost it in the final minute. Now the offense has to stay on. Third and four. And that ball incomplete, as it was intended for Anthony Parker. A turnover on downs. The seventh turnover. And the Rough Riders have just about confirmed their reservation.
Well, that will be in the headlines tomorrow. There's no question if Saskatchewan can finish this off with 2:13 to go. The turnover issue for the Calgary Stampeders will be one of the headlines. But I really believe this game was the battle of the trenches was a big part of how this game has evolved. In a game that didn't matter in the standings, John Huffnagel lost three key players against the BC Lions.
So the Rough Riders take over. Calgary 42-yard line. Corey Sheets has been a key man today. Said he didn't want John Cornish in his locker for the Grey Cup. And he has done his part. 25 carries, 137 yards.
See, G. Roy Simon just reminding Corey Sheets, the game's not over. There's 2:07 left, and saying, don't start getting into shouting match now. Both guys like Corey Sheets and Dwight Anderson, guys like that, have been very vocal in the past, have been quiet and focused on the job at hand here tonight.
Boy, the gag order run on Dwight Anderson has been effective, hasn't it? And Sheets somehow burst through and got a first down. What an exclamation point on his game with that run to move the chains, and that'll take more time off the clock. Riders are feeling it now and just have to stay composed on the sidelines. Weston Dressler on the field was already starting a victory dance. Well, he was the best running back in the Canadian Football League in the first half of the season. And he's been the best running back today. And they're going to feed him the football again. And he'll run over people. Corey Sheets outside looking for the end zone. And is it a touchdown? No, they'll mark him at the one. To make sure he's ready to go next week. Darian Durant knows, Corey Sheets knows, and it's a 30-yard romp to set up first and goal at the one.
And after this run, Keon Raymond knows how good of a running back Corey Sheets is. Watch the contact in the hole as an undersized Keon Raymond tries to hold his own against Corey Sheets. He lowers his pad level, runs over 25.
It's under review by the command center.
They'll take a look and see if the plane was crossed by Corey Sheets.
Did step right on the pylon in the corner here. So they will review it. And was he in? One more. Well, the right foot's there. Did the ball break the plane? Doesn't look like there's enough evidence to overturn the call on the field. And well, the Rough Riders are mine because they'll get a chance to take more time off the clock. Although a score is going to finish it off.
There's a lower angle look at it, but you're right. Of course, it crosses the plane, not the foot. In fact, you can be standing in the end zone and reach back for the football, and it wouldn't be counted as a touchdown.
After review, the ruling on the field has been confirmed right by replay. First down.
So it is first down, a 30-yard run for Sheets.
First down, just as good.
First and goal at the one. 175 yards.
I think I just heard one of those offensive linemen said, third, 1 yard line, just as good.
Last time they met in a showdown that helped decide home field advantage, Sheets held to 42 yards. Was upset he didn't get the ball. No issue with that today, and he'll reach in for the touchdown and the finishing touch for a Western final victory pending for the Saskatchewan Roughriders.
And once again, Darian Durant has come to play in the playoffs, 2-0 against Calgary in West Finals. And in this game, with the running of Corey Sheets and Jock Sanders in combination, Durant completes 80% of his passes in this game. Close to 300 yards.
Celebration on at the sidelines. It's going to be a cold Gatorade shower with still a little time on the clock. Milo adds the extra point. 18 points off turnovers for Corey Chamberlain's crew. And just took a look around McMahon Stadium. And this was a more so than most Saskatchewan Calgary games, largely a Calgary crowd. The only people left now are wearing green.
Yeah, everyone talked about the running of Darian Durant in the semifinal, and justifiably so. 97 yards, a personal best for him. But he can beat you with his arm as well.
He led them to the Grey Cup in 09 and 10, the heartbreak here in 2009, but he's going to get another chance to complete the resume. Told us before the first game of the year, he actually visualized being in the game, visualized how it would end, and now he's going to get a chance to make it reality. Squib kick downfield for Larry Taylor. Dancing around and hitting the turf at the 30.
You know, and what a season for the Calgary Stampeders, too. I know it's not going to end the way they want it to, but this has been a plug-and-play team for John Huffnagel all year long. And despite just an unbelievable amount of injuries that they've had to overcome, Nick Lewis went down early, Marquay McDaniel in the receiving core. They've gone through a lot of different receivers, their defensive secondary, and then to lose the interior of their defensive line the last game. It finally caught up to them.
Oh, Levi Mitchell in. Is he the quarterback of the future? Is he the man they will protect for the expansion draft? Walter, the University of Calgary Dino product. The Dinos winning a big game in the Mitchell Bowl yesterday, and at first conditions here against Western. Never has a three-quarterback system ever worked better than I think it did here this season for the Calgary Stampeders. Mitchell gets it away, and this is should have been picked off. Should have been easy pickings for Rod Williams, who's had a good day otherwise on the corner for Saskatchewan.
He's been on a mission.
One more week, man.
Despite the challenges when they went through a bit of a losing streak in the middle of the season, Darian Durant headed into the playoffs ready to go. You could tell by his focus, and you saw those numbers over the two playoff games off the hook break.
Just thought of a Twitter reference. People in Saskatchewan don't know what I mean. This one's Darian's fault, too. So many times he's to blame when things go wrong. It led to a hashtag on Twitter for popular Darian's fault. Well, for the second straight week, it's their fault. They're Grey Cup bound.
And it was the formula that worked so well for them all year.
Hell yeah.
Nice balance.
I don't want this trophy.
But with the quarterback that can pull the trigger and execute, if you take away his legs and contain him right, he'll beat you with his arm.
Excuse me, Sister. I just hear him say, I don't want this trophy. Thinking about another one next week. Will be a trophy presentation at the end of this game.
My guess is he doesn't touch it.
Hand off in inside the Walter as the clock drains. There is a flag.
You know, Corey Sheets has been in competition basically with John Cornish all season long for that rushing title and talked all week about putting that personal race aside for this game, focusing on the bigger picture. We saw some key blocks early in the game.
Saskatchewan, 10-yard penalty, first down Calgary.
Early in the game when Darian Durant was looking for Weston Dressler on that touchdown pass, Corey Sheets stepped up and made a real nice block on Juwan Simpson. So he did just what he said he was going to do during the week, which is to put the personal stuff aside for the greater good.
Roughriders won both games early in the season against Hamilton, weeks 4 and 5, but that's a much different Ticat team now. Well, Levi Mitchell can't find anybody. Now he'll take off and look up. He's caught from behind. There's Alex Hall with the tackle. 16 seconds remaining.
Well, the biggest question, I think, for this Saskatchewan defense coming in was, could they contain John Cornish? He had a little bit of success in the third quarter, but they eliminated him in the first, and that was a real difference as well.
Fake to Walter. Got Fuller incomplete. Time out, and the Saskatchewan Roughriders are headed back home to host the Grey Cup in 2013 against the Tiger Cats, Henry Burris and Kent Austin. Who writes this stuff? Roughriders, Ticats in Grey Cup 101. Well, what a performance by Corey Chamberlain's team, and an unusual day for John Huffnagel's squad that self-destructed here with seven turnovers on the day.
Well, for John Huffnagel, it wasn't just the fact that they had the turnovers, but it was after big plays in a couple of cases. It just took all the momentum away from his football team, and they could just never get it back. Drew Tate gave him a bit of a spark when he started the second half, but when Brad Sinopoli fumbled after another big play, really took the wind out of their sails.
Let's check in with Lee Jones and Corey Sheets.
Yeah, thanks a lot, Chris. Corey Sheets able to run the ball extremely well against this Calgary defense. What worked for you guys today?
Pretty much everything. We knew coming in this game, we were going to have to be a hard-fought battle, and that we were going to have to be physical up front. And that O-line, they was very physical. They was opening up some big holes that we used to see in the beginning of the season, and I'm glad they pulled it out today.
You talked about you didn't want to see John Cornish in your stall. What did your defense do? What did you see that we were able to stop him in the first half, not let him run the ball?
Man, they had a fire in their belly that was unbelievable. They came out and just took it to that team every single play. And you've seen it, it's been coming up, big turnovers. No matter if they had a big play downfield, our defense stayed on top of them and make sure we had a turnover.
They've been talking about this all through training camp even. The Grey Cup in Saskatchewan, you are now officially in it. What does that mean to you right now?
Hey, Regina, we coming home, baby. We'll see you in a couple hours. Meet us at the airport, baby. Let's go!
Chance to do what the BC Lions did in 2011, the Toronto Argonauts did in 2012, and now the Saskatchewan Roughriders on home turf will get that opportunity in Grey Cup 101 in 2013. Well, this will bring back some memories of number of 89, of course, for my partner and all those Saskatchewan fans when it was one of the greatest games in Grey Cup history between those two teams. And of course, Hamilton Tiger Cat fans of a certain age will remember 72 when they beat the Rough Riders on their home turf at Ivor Wynn on a field goal by Ian Sunter. Rough Riders are headed to the dressing room. There will be a trophy presentation here, and we will return to McMahon for that. The celebration on in Rider Nation. Corey Sheets and company after a Western final win.